G'day everybody, welcome to another Affinity Photo composite tutorial. This week I've got a space theme composite for you. As you can see, I've got all my assets here on the right hand side, and we're going to just start off with this pure black layer. First thing we're going to do is add some stars to that layer, and we're going to add two lots of stars. I've got this second lot of stars here that I'll turn on, and on this second lot of stars I'm going to change the blend mode to screen. You can see we've got some really nice detail in those stars. I've also got a picture of planet Earth here. I've already cut planet Earth out and just placed it in the middle of the picture, and that looks pretty good about there. What I'm going to do with my planet Earth picture, I'm going to add a Gaussian blur here, and it's just going to be 1 pixel. Just to blur that into the background a tiny little bit. Also going to add an exposure. So we'll come down here to exposure. We'll drag this exposure just to affect the planet Earth here, and we'll make that really quite dark. Now on that exposure level, we'll come to our brushes and we'll pick a nice soft brush, and we'll come over here to our brushes. We've got a flow of about 25%, which is pretty good. Make sure we're on that exposure adjustment. I'll make my brush a little bit bigger using my right and left bracket keys, and you can see that I'm painting in black, and I'm just going to bring that light back onto this side of the planet Earth. Drop my flow right down to about 2 or 3%, and then just sort of grade that in a little bit, and that looks pretty good. We've got the back of planet Earth quite dark. The next picture I'm going to bring in is a picture of my astronaut here. So I've got this picture of an astronaut. Again, I've already cut the astronaut out. While I've got my brush, and I'm going to change my flow back to 25%, I'm going to have a lot smaller brush using my right and left bracket keys, and I'm going to zoom in my command plus just on the face mask here, and I'm going to make that face mask just darker, and you'll see why I'm doing that a little bit later. So just darken that up a little bit. I don't mind some of those little lights still on the face mask there, but just making it a little bit darker, and that looks pretty good. Just while we're zoomed in here, the next picture that we're going to bring in is a picture of a face. I've got this picture here, just cut the face out of just a picture that I found on one of the free sites, and all of the pictures that I'm using here will be listed below for you to go and use yourself. So let's come over to our move tool. Let's just see if we can manipulate this face into our face mask here, and you just need to play around with it a little bit. What I'm going to do is add a mask onto that. So on our mask here, and I'm on the mask layer, and I'm going to come over here to my gradient tool. I'm just going to start sort of outside the face and just quite big. I'm going to try and just fade that into the mask a little bit. About like that looks pretty good. Grab my move tool again, back on the face, and just manipulate it just sort of where you want it. I think that looks pretty good. But also what I'm going to do is just use my little smudge tool a bit, the really small brush, just round the edges here. Quite happy with that for now. Let's go Command Zero. We can always play with that a little bit later. Might just move it back a little bit. You can have a play around with that a little bit later. So I'm happy with that at the moment. Maybe a touch bigger though. Maybe about like that. Okay, so we've got our face in place. The next thing I've got is this picture of broken glass here. So what I'm going to do with this picture, again, change the blend mode to screen and make that smaller. A lot smaller. Just manipulate that sort of maybe about there. Looks pretty good. So we've got our broken glass there. Also got a couple of other pictures of broken glass, and this one's sort of like a glass explosion. It's actually a light bulb exploding, which I sort of like the roundness of it here. So I'm going to change that to screen as well and turn it round, and you can see this sort of looks like the front of a helmet. So let's just manipulate that into place about there. What I'm going to do is make another copy of that with Command J. And this one I'm going to come up to Arrange and Flip Horizontal. And then I'm just going to turn it a little bit with this handle here just to make it look like that glass is blowing out into space there. So that looks pretty good. We can come back to our face, and on that mask, I think we need to brighten our face up a bit. So let's have a look, make our brush a little bit bigger, change to white, just using X on my keyboard. I just want to bring that face out a little bit, change back to black. We'll have a play with that around a little bit later as well. Command zero, we've got our picture with our glass explosion. So I'm quite happy with that. Let's bring in our pipe now. Let's make it a little bit bigger and we'll add an exposure to it. We'll make that quite dark. Let's position that pipe. Let's make our picture a little bit smaller with our command minus so we can just see what we're going to do. Let's position it right in front here. Sort of like that looks pretty good. Command zero. On our exposure, let's grab our brush and let's just bring some of that color back in. Let's go back to about 8 here. X on our keyboard. Just manipulating that there. That looks pretty good. I'm pretty happy with that. Make another copy of that pipe. Command J. And let's bring one behind our astronaut. Grab our move tool, make that a bit smaller. What we might do is just move that all the way around. Just move that up into place. Maybe about there looks pretty good. And on that one with the exposure, might just make a bit brighter so we can see it. Okay, I'm going to make one more copy of that pipe, Command J. Again, we're going to make that a little bit smaller. Arrange, flip horizontal again. And what I want to do is try and get that pipe look like it's going into that hole there. That a little bit bigger. And let's zoom in with that. Just manipulate it. About like that looks pretty good. So command zero. So we've got our pipes just floating around here. On that one that we've just done, we might go to the exposure with our brush. And again, just bring in some of that color there so we can see that a little bit better. So I'm happy with the way that is looking. So what we're going to do now is bring in some of these asteroids. So again, I've got these picture of asteroids here. I'm going to make it quite big, put it right up the top here, make that quite big, and we can also just manipulate by turning that around a little bit. I'll make another copy, Command J, and I want one right behind my astronaut as well. And these ones I'll just go flip vertical, and they're going to be behind my astronaut here. Now we've got those in place as well. So let's take care of our astronaut a little bit more now. So let's come back down to our astronaut. What I'm going to do is add a recolor. Just clip that to my astronaut and bring that right up into those dark blues and then darken that down a bit. Maybe take the saturation down a little bit. Just have a play with that. And on that recolor, still coming over to our brush, let's bring our flow back up again, 24-25%, and we're just going to add some of our light back in to our helmet up here. I'm going to drop that down to about 5%, make my brush a little bit bigger, bring that back in a little bit. On my astronaut, I will add an exposure as well. Clip that to my astronaut, make that a lot darker as well. And then again, with my brush, bring in some of that light. Another thing with my astronaut that I'm going to do, I'm going to add an effect. So I'm going to come down here to the layer effects. I'm going to come over here to outer glow and change the color to that really dark blue. Just bring the radius up till it's sort of goes like a glow, and then bring the intensity all the way down and drop the opacity as well. Just give that a little bit of a glow on our astronaut there. Command zero. I'm pretty happy with that at the moment. So I'm just going to go layer and merge visible. Gives me one layer that includes all of the other layers that we have down below here. Come over here to my develop persona. And what I'm going to do is bring up the vibrance. my white balance, I'm just going to bring it into the yellows a tiny little bit, just give it that little bit of a pop there. And up on my details, detail refinement, I'll bring to about 50%, looking pretty good. And I think that maybe the contrast down a little bit and the clarity all the way up. And I think I'm going to develop that. So there you go, everybody. That is my composite tutorial, my space theme composite for this week. As usual, I will list all of the photos below that I've used. Some of them will be available on the Buy Me a Coffee site, already cut out for you to grab and use straight away. While you're there, you can also support my channel if you like. You can also hit that super thanks link below. If you did really enjoy the tutorial this week, please give it a thumbs up. Please consider subscribing. And until next time, I'll say to you, stay well, stay safe, and I'll see you in my next video.